Hi, I'm Scott Sissel. I'm the product manager for Tanzu Application Platform, and I'm here today to talk to you about Tanzu Application Platform and some of the core concepts behind it. At its core, Tanzu Application Platform, or TAP, is a developer platform that helps developers get their application into production quickly and securely while abstracting away a lot of the operational concepts around Kubernetes away from them, so they don't have to worry about that when they're developing their app. So when you look at the three personas that this is targeting, there are your developers, your operators, and then your security team. The core principle TAP is based on is this concept called separation of concern. A developer shouldn't have to worry about the operational complexity required to run their application on Kubernetes in production. So you can have the operators and security teams implement that and focus on that for them, where the developers can focus just on their code and application business logic. So when we look at the four, the two areas of the platform, there are two main loops that we talk about from a development lifecycle perspective. You have your inner loop, and then your outer loop. Let's talk about the inner loop first. The inner loop is all about quick feedback and quick iteration when a developer is developing their application in their local environment. There are four key outcomes that we want to focus on for TAP for the inner loop for developers. There's learn, discover, and start, iterate, and debug. So if we talk about each of these outcomes, the first part is learning. You want to be able to have a developer come in and learn about the technology they're using and the application concepts they're going to be developing as part of the platform in general. And then we talk about discover and start. So the outcome we want to focus on discover and starting is that quick start. So this takes the form of app accelerators in TAP, where a developer can come in and have pre-baked templates and configurations that will help jumpstart their development process for their application. The next we go into iterate. We want to be able to allow developers to quickly iterate on the platform in a local environment that gives them quick feedback loops so they can debug and test their application. And finally, we get to debug. You need to be able to dig in deep and see what's going on with your application to understand what you need to fix and what you need to troubleshoot as you get your code into a ready state. At that point, when you've gone through and you're confident your code is in the good spot, you commit your code and put it to a source code repo. Now this takes us to the outer loop. The outer loop is all about the path to production. So this is about your operators and your security personas, making sure that any code that goes into a shared environment or production environment is operationally sound and secure by default. So let's talk about the four outcomes we're focusing on here. We have test and build, scan, sign, and store. Deploy, and then run. So let's start with test and build. So test and build is all about running your code through your testing environment or your kind of unit test and making sure that it's acting as you thought it should act And then buildings all around a consistent build process that uses the build opinions defined by the operators and security team to make sure things are consistent, and using kind of blessed artifacts inside of the inner production or shared environment. Next, we go to scan, sign, and store. So scan, sign, and store is all about security scanning and making sure what's going into production is audited and compliant with what the security team has deemed appropriate for putting a workload in production. And then let's get to deploy next. So deploy is the act of actually pushing your code out to production environments, whether that's multiple clusters, single cluster, whatever. This is all about taking that and pushing it out there easily to your across data centers or single environments. And then finally, run. This is the runtime aspect of running your application at scale in production. So we look at these two inner loops, or these two loops, the inner loop and the outer loop. And we look at kind of one core concept of TAP that really brings us together. And then this is what we call supply chains. So a supply chain is really at the core of the DevSecOps mindset. A supply chain brings in the operational and security concepts into the inner loop for developer because it allows a developer to focus on just their code, but then as a configuration that's defined for them inside of their template in their apps accelerator will allow them to have those security and operational principles baked into their application right away. So they can be confident that when they're focusing just on their application logic, that they're developing their application in a production-ready environment or a mindset that will allow it to get to production and in a safe, secure way, and then run at scale in a secure way in the future. All right, I hope you enjoyed what I had to talk about today for TAP and some of the core principles here, and look forward to you for getting your feedback and testing out TAP in the future. Thanks.